We're with John Eldredge. We are talking about prayer. His book is called Moving Mountains, Praying with Passion, Confidence, and Authority. John, before we went to the break, we're talking about unanswered prayer. It's the elephant in the room. We've all prayed for people we loved and cared about. They weren't healed. What do we do with that, and how do we maintain that passion to keep praying when we don't see answers to prayers that we're really desperate to see answered?
Yeah, first you have to start with the broken heart there of inviting Jesus into your disappointment, inviting him into your loss of heart, because we want to give up. We want to abandon something so beautiful and powerful as prayer. And what I want to say is God is always good. You've got to hang on to that. God is always good. We may not always see his goodness in this earth, but God is always good. And don't give up next time. Because yes, not every prayer is answered the way we want, but a lot of them are.
Yeah.
A lot of our prayers are. And so don't let one big disappointment keep you from pressing on in the future, praying for other loved ones or praying for his guidance. Or, you know, your life of prayer with God is so important. Don't give up.
How about praying for people that you want to see know Jesus? Mm-hmm. And you've been praying for 35, 40 years. Mm-hmm. I know they have their will, the prayer of intercession, intervention.
Yes.
How do we, again, maintain that passion that you talk about, that confidence, that authority, when we're not maybe seeing the results that we desire to see?
Okay, you are battling for a human soul. You are in the fight. You are partnering with God. So this isn't going to just go quick, folks, right? Not a marriage isn't quick, parenting isn't quick, prayer isn't quick, okay? Sticking with it and praying some of those scriptures. For example, Paul says in 2 Corinthians that the God of this age has blinded the mind of the unbeliever. Well, we pray into that. Lord, take away the blinders. Jesus, break through the cloud and the veil of unbelief. We use the scriptures to pray for the unbeliever. Paul has this beautiful prayer in Ephesians 1, that God would reveal himself to you. We pray that, Lord, open the eyes of their hearts, as Paul prays. So we can use the scripture with great power in prayer.
I just want to get to one thing, and we're just about out of time here. But a lot of people, they would not say this, but it's in their action. God is sovereign. He'll do whatever he wants anyway. My prayers don't really matter.
Exactly. And you do not see that in scripture. Book of Acts, chapter 12. Peter is in prison. James has been killed. They're about to kill Peter, but it says this, but the church was praying strenuously for him. Same word used of the prayers of Jesus in Gethsemane. That's how hard they're praying. Okay? They intervene in prayer. Peter is set free. Okay, folks, you have a role in the kingdom of God here on earth. God uses prayer. It's not just zap and it's over, right? We are his partners. It's just like the gospel. God could broadcast the gospel to the whole world tomorrow, let everybody know about Jesus, but that's not how he does it. He uses you and me.
Next time we come back, I want to talk about the zap prayer that you talk about. And we believe in prayer at 100 Huntley Street and all its crossroads. And we have amazing people standing by. If you're dealing with maybe a sickness or you've been praying for a relative and they have not come to know Jesus, well, John has given us some great advice here. Persevere. Keep going. Keep praying. Our prayer lines are open all the time, 24-7, 1-866-273-4444. Thank you, John. Look forward to having you back in the near future on 100 Huntley Street.
Great to be with you, Greg. Thanks.
We'll have more of our program right after this.